Hello learners, our today's session is on financial markets. In this session, we will cover meaning of financial market, major participants in the financial market, functions of financial market, and segments of the financial market, in which we will cover capital market and money market, both. So, we'll start with the definition of financial market. The market of an economy where funds are transacted between the fund surplus and fund scarce individuals and groups is known as the financial market. In a broader term, financial market may be described as any marketplace where buyers and sellers participate in the trade of financial assets such as equities, bonds, currencies, and derivatives. So in financial market, the transactions of financial assets has been taken place between those who have surplus funds and those who require that funds. Next is the major participants in Indian financial market. So first is the individual. Individuals or household who save the money or who have surplus money, they invest their money in the company shares and or government securities in the expectation of return. The firms or corporates, the companies required fund for their growth, expansion, and diversification. For this, they issue share in the market and raise capital. Government required fund to meet its fiscal deficit. And government also invests the surplus funds in companies and financial institutions. Next are the regulators. There are different regulatory bodies in India who regulate the products and different sectors of the financial markets. For example, RBI regulate the money market, SEBI, that is Securities Exchange Board of India, they regulate the capital market. Insurance products in India are regulated by Insurance Regulatory Development Authority. And besides that, there are various regulatory agencies who regulate the different sectors and products of the financial market. And last is the market intermediaries. Market intermediaries are those individuals and institutions who act as a link between the two parties. They are underwriters. Financial institutions. In financial institutions, we have IFCI, that is Industrial Financial Corporation of India, ICICI, Industrial Credit Investment Corporation of India, SFCs, IDBI, UTI. So these financial institutions, they also invest funds in the different companies. Besides that, there are banks, brokers, depositories, custodians, mutual funds. So they are the market intermediaries. So learner, this is all about the participants in the financial market, and they play a very important role in the different sectors of the financial market. Next is the functions of financial market. The important functions of financial market are price determination, funds mobilization, risk sharing, easy access, liquidity, capital formation, reduction in transaction cost. So next, we will discuss each these function one by one. First is the price determination. Prices of the financial instruments or securities are determined through the forces of demand and supply in the market. Then funds mobilization. Financial market can easily mobilize the funds from those who have excess funds and transfer to those who require that funds. So financial market act as a link between the savers and those who require that funds. Third one is risk sharing. In financial market, risk is distributed among the several participants in the enterprise. Fourth is easy access. Financial market provides the platform to the buyers and sellers where they can easily access the transactions. Next is provide liquidity to financial assets. In financial market, financial securities like shares, bond, and debentures, they can be bought and sold easily. So financial market provides platform to convert securities in cash. For example, we have NSE, BSE. These are the stock exchanges where the trading takes place. Next is the capital formation. Financial market provide the channel through which the saving of the investors flow in the country, which aid in the capital formation of country. So in a financial market, the savings of the investors are converted into capital. And last one is reduction in transaction cost and provision of the required information. The various types of information are required to the traders. The financial market provides complete information regarding price, availability, and cost of various financial instruments. So investors and companies do not spend much to get this information as it is readily available in the financial market. So this is all about the functions of the capital market, financial market. Next is the segments of India financial market. The organized financial markets are capital market and money market. Capital market has further two complementary market, primary market, secondary market, whereas money market has unorganized market and organized market. So we'll start with the capital market. What is capital market? A capital market is a market for securities, debt and equity, where business enterprises and government can raise long-term funds. Long-term funds means who are issued for more than one year. It is defined as a market in which money is provided for periods longer than a year, as the raising of short-term funds take place on other markets. So for short-term funds, there is money market. The capital market includes the stock market, that is equity securities, and the bond market, that is the debt securities. Next are the various capital market instruments. So there are various capital market instruments which are used to raise funds. Here are the instruments, direct and derivatives. Indirect, we have equity shares, preference shares, debentures, debt instruments. The first two, equity shares and preference shares, they have ownership authority. Means equity shareholders and preference shareholders, they are considered as the owner of the company, and their risk is also very high. Whereas the debenture holder and debt instruments holder, they are the creditors of the company, and their risk is low, and they receive a fixed rate of interest semi-annually and annually. The debt instruments cover the government securities. Government securities are issued by RBI, Reserve Bank of India, on behalf of the government. Indira Vikas Patra, Kisan Vikas Patra, these are the example of government securities. Then corporate bonds issued by public and private companies. Then we have certificates of deposits, commercial paper. These two instruments, when they are issued for more than 1 year, then they come under the capital market instruments. And when they are issued less than 1 year, when their maturity period is less than 1 year, they come under the money market instruments. Then there is zero coupon bonds, fixed deposits, national savings certificates. So these all are the debt instruments. In NSE, there is a separate platform known as wholesale debt market where these debt instruments are traded. Next are the derivatives. Derivatives are the financial instruments whose value is derived from the value of underlying assets, which can be equity shares, precious stones, commodities, market index, interest rate, etc. Investors invest in derivative market for speculation and hedging, and they want to minimize their risk. That's why they invest in derivatives. So in India, we have derivative instruments like forward, future, options. Besides that, we have swaps and warrants also. So these are the capital market instruments, which are issued in the capital market to raise long-term funds. Next is the capital market segments. Capital market has two complementary markets, primary market, secondary market. Primary market, new issue market. Primary market is the market where the securities, shares, bonds, debentures are issued to investor to raise funds. In two cases, fresh funds are issued in the primary market. First, when a new company comes into existence and it required funds for its operations. At that time, securities are issued in the market and funds are raised. And in the second case, when there is already an existing company and it required funds for its expansion and development, at that time also, shares are issued, securities are issued in the market and funds are raised. These securities are issued through the mode of public issue of prospectus, private placement, right issues, and preferential issues. Next are the features of primary market. In the primary market, companies issue securities directly to investors. So company directly issues shares to the investors. After receiving the prescribed funds, the company allots shares, securities to the investors. And primary market facilitates company to raise capital for setting new business ventures or for expanding or modernizing the existing business. Next is the secondary market or stock exchange market. Secondary market is the market where the existing securities are traded in the stock exchange. So in primary market, new shares are issued. And in secondary market, the shares which are already exist in the market, they are traded in the, trading means buying and selling of these shares are done in the stock exchange. It means buying and selling the shares to the stock exchange. For example, NSE, that is National Stock Exchange, and BSE, Bombay Stock Exchange, are the two biggest stock exchanges in India. Besides that, there is OTCEI, that is Over-the-Counter Exchange of India, and some regional stock exchanges are also in India where the trading takes place. BSE is the oldest stock exchange in Asia, whereas NSE is the largest stock exchange in the country in terms of trading volumes. It offers a fully automated screen-based trading system known as the National Exchange for Automated Trading System. Features of secondary market. The secondary market provides liquidity to the investors. Investors can buy and sell the shares anytime, and they can convert their shares into cash easily. In secondary market, the transaction cost is low because of the high volume of transactions. Secondary market encourages new investment among investors. It also ensures the safety and fair trading for the protection of the investors' interest. So SEBI regulate the capital market, and it ensures the safety and the protection of the investors' interest. Next, we will do the comparison between the primary market and secondary market. So here we have a table of comparison. First is the meaning. Primary market is a place where new shares are issued, and secondary market is a place where already existing shares are traded. Second is the another name. Another name of primary market is new issue market, whereas secondary market is known as aftermarket or share market. Third one is type of purchasing. In primary market, there is a direct purchasing from company, whereas in secondary market there is an indirect. Here the investors, they do buying and selling from each other. There is no direct purchasing from the company. Fourth one is financing. Primary market helps to supply funds to the budding enterprises, means new enterprises, and also to existing companies for their expansion and diversification. In secondary market, doesn't provide funding to the enterprises. Here only the trading of already existing shares are done. Buying and selling of shares are done in the secondary market. Fifth basis of comparison is how many times security can be sold. In primary market, only once, and in secondary market, multiple times. Sixth one is who will gain the amount on the sale of shares. In primary market, it is the company who sell the shares and get the cash, get the fund, get the capital. And in secondary market, investor, the seller who sell the shares, he will get the amount. Seventh one is buying and selling. In primary market, buying and selling is between the company and the investors. And in secondary market, buying and selling is between the investors. Then is the intermediary. In primary market, there is underwriter. In secondary market, brokers, they are the intermediaries. Underwriter play a very important role in primary market. From the pre-issue of shares till the final allotment of shares to the investors, underwriters manage all this. Next is the price. In primary market, the price of share is fixed. Whereas in secondary market, it fluctuates and depends upon the demand and supply. So learners, this is the comparison between the primary market and secondary market. So till now, we have covered the capital market, primary market and secondary market. Next we have the money market. In money market, we have unorganized market and organized market. So we'll start with the money market. Definition of money market is a market where short-term lending and borrowing take place between the cash surplus and cash scarce side. So in other words, we can say that money market is the short-term financial market of an economy. In this market, money is traded between individuals or groups, that is financial institutions, banks, government, companies, etc., who are either cash surplus or cash scarce. Trading is done on a rate known as discount rate, which is determined by the market. Segment of the money market. Money market operates in both organized and unorganized channels in India. The transaction takes place through the intermediaries, brokers, or directly between the trading sides. So money market has two channels, unorganized money market and organized money market. So first is unorganized money market. What is unorganized money market? Unorganized money market is the market whose activities are not regulated like organized market, but their activities are recognized by government. Unorganized money market include the indigenous bankers, money lenders, chit funds, nidhis. So the categories of unorganized money market are, first is the indigenous bankers. Indigenous bankers receive deposit and lend money to the individuals or private firms. There are basically four such bankers in the country functioning right now. They are Gujarati Sharofs, Multani and Shikarpuri Sharofs, Marwadi Kayas and Chetiars. Next are the money lenders. They are the most localized form of money market in India. There are two forms, professional money lenders and non-professional money lenders. Professional money lenders lend their money and get interest on them. Whereas non-professional lenders may be the businessmen who lend the money and get the interest as their subsidiary business. Next is the unregulated non-bank financial intermediaries. Unregulated non-banking financial intermediaries are functioning in the form of chit funds, nidhis, and they are operating in South India, where they lend money to only their members and loan companies. They charge very high interest rate, that is from 36% to 48% per annum, and have selective reach in the economy. Next, we have the organized money market. The organized form of money market in India is just close to 3 decades old. It was the Chakravarti Committee in 1985, which for the first time underlined the need of an organized money market in the country, and the Vogel Committee in 1987 laid the blueprint for its development. Money market is regulated by RBI in India. Total of 8 instruments are designed to be used by different categories of business and industrial firms. So here are the money market instruments. They are the treasury bills, certificate of deposits, commercial paper, commercial bill, call money market mutual funds, repos and reverse repos, and cash management bill. They are the 8 money market instruments which are currently operating in India. So trading in the money market is conducted over the telephone, followed by written confirmation from both the borrowers and lenders. So learners, this is about the money market. So learners, this is all about this session of financial market. In our next session, we will cover the money market instruments in more detail. Thank you.